What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing an update on Cardano ADA token. And on today's video, first of all, I will show you where we are on the price chart and how we get there. Then I will continue with the fundamental news that might drive the price of this token. And at the end of this video, I will show you my forecast for the potential outcome for the price action. And before we get into all of that, if you guys would like to take a part in the limited time offer from Webull and earn two free stocks valued up to $2,300, just open new account, deposit only $5 and choose your free stocks, link in my description. So let's start with the price chart. I made my previous video right here at this point. Let me switch to 4 hours time frame. I made my previous video right here at the level of 0.236 Fibonacci retracement level from the very bottom to the very top. And I've told you that from this point we might go higher, and my main assumption was that we have this retracement, simple zigzag retracement, and it's already finished because we have several confluence levels. First of all, we hit 0.236. It is not the most probable level of trend reversal, but still it is a Fibonacci retracement level. Next one, we have this 55 exponential moving average, and it might act as a support or resistance. And right here, it acts exactly as a very good support because we have only week below this yellow line. And then we bounced back and we continue to go higher. And next one is this line. This is the confluence level because we have this line as a resistance at this point, and as well as a resistance right here. And we hit it to the tick and bounce back from it. And my main assumption was that we have to hit our all-time high. It is around $2.47. And right here, it is our all-time high level. So, we hit it to the tick, and congratulations to all of you who took this trade. And from our entry point, you're up for about 26, almost 27%. And it is very, very good gains within just a couple of days. So, and right here, I nailed this very top to the tick. I've told you right here at this very point that we had a bearish divergence. Let me show it to you. We had definitely bearish divergence, and from this point we had to go lower, and basically it happened. So I nailed two recent moves out of two, and it is quite good result. And let's continue with some fundamentals of entire crypto market, and I will do a technical analysis in several minutes. So the total market cap for now is $2.03 trillion. It's up for about 2.54% during the last day. And as you can see, all major cryptocurrencies are in green, and we have very good bounce for Bitcoin and for Ethereum, and all other cryptocurrencies are in green as well. And as you can see, Cardano has the highest profits during the last 24 hours, and it has almost the highest profits, basically highest profits among top 10 coins during last 7 days. And it is a very good sign. For now, it is at the third place according to CoinMarketCap, and let's continue with their numbers. For now, its total market cap is $77.88 billion. It's up for 13.23%. And its total tradable volume during the last 24 hours is almost $8.5 billion. It's up for about almost 70%. Very good volume. And this volume, as I already mentioned, we have to have higher volume with an impulsive movement to the upside compared to the volume of the retracement. And right here, as you can see, we have, let me show it to you more thoroughly. We have again very good volume with this movement to the upside, and it is very significant for this token. So let's continue with some fundamental news. And just several hours ago on CoinDesk, we have this article that is titled "Cardano hits all-time high as investors await smart contracts. Expectations are rising for the blockchain to implement smart contract functionality by next month." And I have to say that we have a deadline. It is a September the 12th. And it is a final release date of Alonzo upgrade. And we have to have smart contracts with Cardano on September the 12th. And it is very good functionality for this token. And I made a very detailed analysis what it is all about in one of my previous video. You can find the link in the description below. But for now, let's continue with the technical analysis. And before we dive deep right here, please subscribe to my channel, hit notification bell and hit the like button. This helps me a lot. So, guys, let me give you in details the breakdown of last wave. And let me show you this. We have two possibilities, basically. First of all, on a 4 hours time frame, we might complete all five waves and we hit this resistance line with the very top of our fifth wave on a smaller scale. And it might be like this. This is the first, second, third, fourth, and fifth one. And we have very good volume with this movement to the upside, and we don't violate any rule of Elliott wave theory. Our third wave is longer than the first one, and it cannot be the shortest one among all five impulsive waves. And we have extension in fifth wave. In this case, if we complete all five waves, we have following breakdown. Right here we have this as our first wave, second, third, fourth, and fifth. This is the retracement. Next one, we have this is our potentially first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. And you might know that five waves on a smaller scale, it is only one wave on a greater scale. This means we might have this is our first wave, second, third, fourth, and fifth. And let me clean this chart a little bit. And with this breakdown, we might have a retracement from the very bottom to the very top. And if I'm correct, we might have these levels as a potential entry levels. So definitely we have the level of around $1.91. It is a 0.382 level. It is a confluence level with this bottom, with this 55 exponential moving average, with this previous resistance that was the resistance right here and right here. And for now, it might act as a support. And if I'm correct, and if my breakdown is correct, we might hit it. And then from this point, we might go higher to hit all-time highs, to exceed the all-time high level, and to achieve major targets. But if I'm wrong, and let me show you how it is possible, if I switch to 1 hour time frame, we have this breakdown on a smaller scale. This is our first wave, second, third, fourth, and fifth. This is ABC correction to the downside. This is the bottom of our third wave. And for now, this is only the next wave, and we have to have one more retracement, small retracement, and we might hit, we might break this resistance with the next leg to the upside. And let me show you right here. On a slightly bigger scale, we might have this is our first wave, this is our second. For now, this is potentially the top of our third, or maybe we might have one more small leg to the upside. It doesn't matter for now because we don't have much difference. Let's assume that this is the top. Next one, we might have some retracement, and with the fifth wave, we might break this resistance. And what should you do if you want to catch this next leg? Let me do some measurements. If this breakdown is correct, we have to have a pullback. And right here, as you can see, we have a range in between 0.5 and 0.618, 0.65 as potential support line from these tops. And we might hit it. Then, with a good volume, we might have next attempt. And we have two possibilities. We might hit this as double top and have a major retracement, as I already mentioned several minutes ago. Or we might break this to the upside, and with the very bullish sentiment, we might have an extension, huge extension in fifth wave, and we might have some major gains with this price action. But what should you do exactly if you want to benefit from this asset? Basically, we have to keep an eye on this price action, and if we'll go lower, we have to take a look on this level. We have to take a look on the level of around $2.23, then about $2.25 and $2.17. If we will break this level, this will invalidate the impulsive movement of this entire structure, and we might have more chances to hit lower targets. And my first assumption should be correct. Otherwise, if we will have a small retracement to the downside and we might bounce from the 0.5 and have very good volume right here with the green candle, we might break this resistance, and this will give us the opportunity of this breakdown to be true. So, and from the technical standpoint, that's it for now. If you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel with notification bell. In this case, you won't miss my next video. And see you guys and girls next time. Bye!